Hi again.
It is now time to start talking about dimensional analysis. This could be one of the most important topics you will learn this semester. It is a concept that you will use over and over, and once you grasp it, it will be your best friend. So let's start off with a simple problem. We're asked to convert 36 weeks into a year. We're asked 36 weeks is what fraction of a year? I'm simply going to start by putting 36 weeks over 1. And what I'm going to do is multiply it by a special fraction. Now, the special fraction is called a unit fraction because the values on the top and the bottom represent the same amount of time or length or volume as the case may apply. I'm going to use a fraction where I can compare weeks to years. I happen to know that there are 52 weeks. Notice that weeks went across on the bottom, not on the top, so this is different from proportions, and that is the same thing as 1 year. Once I have this set up and I can verify that my units cancel, and they only cancel when they're in opposite parts of the fraction, I now have my answer basically in front of me. The 52 is on the bottom, and what the bottom means is that you divide by 52. So I would take my answer, and there's a couple of ways you can look at it. You can say 36 times 1, and 1 times 52. And that's essentially 36 divided by 52. So it's verified that you actually do divide by 52. If you try to divide 36 by 52 on your calculator, you get an unusual decimal, 0.692307, etc. And it's not an easy decimal to recognize, so what I'll do is just reduce my fraction instead. And I would prefer to leave it as a fraction because the directions said what fraction of a year. Both of these numbers are divisible by 4, so I'm going to reduce them to 9/13. And so what I have here is that 36 weeks is 9/13 of a year. Okay, so it's not quite a whole year yet, but that's okay. I know it's what fraction, and it turns out to be 9/13. One hint about a problem that involves weeks and years, do not assume that there are 4 weeks in every month. If you look at the actual months on a calendar, some months have 4 weeks and some months have more. So please keep that in mind. That's not a conversion you want to use. 4 weeks in a month does not apply. Now suppose that you want to convert pounds to ounces. And what I have here is 9 3/5 pounds, and I want to convert that to ounces. The 3/5 might be bothering you just a little bit, but that's easily solved by dividing 3 by 5 on your calculator. So what I really have here is 9.6 pounds. Feel free to use the abbreviation LB. I'm going to put it over 1. I'm going to multiply it by a unit fraction. But just like above, if I want to get rid of pounds, I have to put it on the bottom. To go from pounds to ounces, which the abbreviation is OZ, and sometimes I'll put a line through it, but OZ is simply fine. I now just need to go back and kind of fill in the blanks. And I need to figure out if I know a conversion from ounces to pounds. I happen to know that there are 16 ounces in 1 pound. Now that I look at my problem, I notice that I have a different looking unit fraction. The numbers again are different, but the weights are the same. And what I can do is 9.6 times 16 and 1 times 1 on the bottom. And so now the 16 is on top. I would not divide by 16, I would multiply. Using my calculator, I've come up with 153.6, and this would be ounces. You can verify that this is ounces because you should notice that the pounds cancel each other out, leaving you with ounces. Now, typically when you write ounces, you won't leave a decimal. If you read about the apothecary system, you'll want to write that as a fraction. So I'll change the 0.6 back to a fraction. Fortunately, I know that 6/10 reduces to 3/5. So when I have 9 3/5 pounds, that is the same thing as 153 3/5 ounces. The next problem I want to show you deals with inches and feet. Suppose that you want to convert 91 inches to feet in inches. I'm going to start off by typing or writing 91 inches over 1. Same things I did before. I'm going to multiply by unit fraction. I'm going to put inches on the bottom, and I know a straight conversion from inches to feet. I know that there are 12 inches in 1 foot. I can tell now that I'll have 91 times 1 across the top and 1 times 12 across the bottom. Now what I notice here is that 12 is not going to divide into 91 evenly. It goes in 7 times, but there is some left over. So one thing I can tell you is it's approximately 7 feet and I don't know how many inches. Okay, so what I'll do next is I can quickly do 7 times 12. That is 84. Well, what that means is I have 84 inches, and the problem originally started with 91 inches. So that means I have 7 more inches to account for. So it turns out that 91 inches is the same thing as 7 feet and 7 inches. This kind of problem shows up when you're asked how tall you are, and usually you'll give your answer in feet and inches. You usually won't tell your answer in just inches. I hope this helps explain some of the basics of dimensional analysis, and on the next video, I will do something a little bit more complicated.